Hello, friends. 2 years ago, I made my first review of a new device at the time, the fourth generation gateway for the Mihome ecosystem. For those interested, there's a link in the description. I was curious about why, with only the Bluetooth mesh interface on board, it was significantly more expensive than the Xiaomi Hub 2, which was released around the same time and, in addition to Bluetooth, also had a Zigbee interface. The declared functionality of local automations, in the scope available at the time of testing, didn't impress me, so I set the device aside for better times. Recently, I decided to check the updates, and as it turned out, this device is of a completely different level. It has truly become a local control center for the smart home. More details to follow, but for now, as usual, I kindly ask you to like this video, as it helps others interested in smart home topics to find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. The version 4 gateway is a square box resembling a TV set-top box, with its black color sharply distinguishing it from other gateways and hubs in the Mihome ecosystem, which are usually white. One of its undeniable advantages is the LAN port, which provides more reliable and stable connectivity compared to Wi-Fi. However, I covered this in more detail in the first video. Here, we'll discuss something else. At the time of this testing, the current firmware version was 3.3.0-0023, and the central hub software version was 0.7.6. These were the two updates I installed before the review. On the right slide, you can see the plugin version. On the left slide, you can see how the device's plugin looked at the time of the first review. Next to it is the current version at the time of filming this video, where a new item appeared, hub features. By entering it, we are taken to a page displaying the IP address and a one-time dynamic code for connection. If you tap on the How to Connect item, another page will open, showing that from a computer connected to the same network, you need to go to the specified address and enter the access code. For proper operation, the manufacturer recommends using Google Chrome. Enter the password digits, which, by the way, are generated separately for each login. After entering the last digit, we are taken to the hub interface. By default, it is in Chinese. Jumping ahead, I'll mention that the instructional videos I found were also in Chinese, so I had to use some imagination here. Let's use the browser's built-in translation function. I switched to English, as it's more convenient and understandable. Let's start with the section, Equipment List. Here, all the devices that I have in my home are displayed, those connected to this gateway, Zigbee devices connected to another gateway, and Wi-Fi devices. They are divided into three categories, fully accessible, partially accessible, and unavailable. Although I had some doubts, I found both the air quality sensor and the robot vacuum cleaner here. The third section lists unavailable devices. What does this mean? For partially accessible devices, it's indicated that they don't support local reporting. We'll figure out what this means later. In the case of unavailable devices, it's simpler. These devices are currently genuinely disconnected and also unavailable in the Mihome plugin. Let's now move on to automations. Their list is currently empty, so click the button in the center of the screen, Create Automation. In the next dialog, give it a name. I recommend using Latin alphabet characters to avoid potential display issues. Here's what an empty template for creating automations looks like. Let's start with the basics. Drag the button, Event Occurrence, onto the field. A device selection dialog opens. Select the Acura button. In the drop-down menu, select an event. Let's choose Click. This is the automation trigger. Now drag the button, Perform an action, onto the field. Select the Philips lamp. Action, turn on. Now connect the trigger and action. Save it. The automation works. Pressing the button turns on the lamp. It doesn't appear in the Mihome app. It's stored in the gateway. In this same block, you can create new automations. I added a trigger for a double press of this button, which toggles the socket state. This organization is very convenient. You can create several automations in one block, for example, for different button presses of one switch or linked by a common task. This resembles packages in Home Assistant. For display convenience, all blocks can be collapsed into a compact view with a double click. Similarly, they can be expanded back. Let's consider the following example. The trigger is the same, a single press of the button. Now we will use the conditions block. It also needs to be dragged onto the field, which will open a list of devices. I select the same lamp. The condition will be its state on. We connect the trigger to the condition. The condition can either be met or not. If it is met, the lamp is on, the action will be to turn off the lamp. We connect the condition to the action. If the condition is not met, the lamp is off. We create a new action, turning on the lamp. Save it. This results in a standard automation where the same trigger, pressing the button, toggles the lamp on and off. Here it is in a compact form. I collapsed everything except the on block so it can be continued further. For example, we can add the next block, setting the brightness level, which is specified manually. Additionally, either the color or the color temperature for white light can be set. In this example, for 1000 Kelvin, neutral light. Here is how this automation looks in compact view. Remember, within this block, multiple automations can be created. The timing block. It allows setting days, every day, weekdays, weekends, or a custom selection. Let's choose a custom option. After this, an additional menu will appear. In it, you can select specific days of the week, for example, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. You can specify either a specific time or sunset or sunrise. Let's set 8 a.m. This will be the trigger. As the action, let's choose the same lamp again. It will turn on. Now let's take the delay block. Here, we'll set it to 5 minutes. We connect it to the first action. Create a new action, turning off the lamp and add it after the delay. Let's return to the previous automation. We use the block when if then. Connect the event of the lamp turning on to the input. Now we take the time period block. Every day, from 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. Draw a line from the green part of the period to the green part of the block E. This will be the condition. If the lamp turns on during the period from 8 a.m. to 9 p.m., the brightness will be 100% and the temperature will be 4000 K. For turning on at other times, set other parameters. Brightness 40%. Temperature, 3000 K. Now this automation considers not only the lamp's state, but also the time it's turned on. Another example. In the events block, choose the temperature and humidity sensor. Event type, humidity, value, more than 75%. The output has both a blue and green section. We choose the action, ventilation relay control. Here it will be turning on. Connect these blocks with a blue arrow. As soon as the value is reached, the ventilation will turn on immediately. Let's choose the same event again. Humidity, less than 60%. An additional block, state over time. Set it to 30 seconds. These blocks are connected with a green arrow, indicating the condition. Choose the action, turning off the ventilation relay. For this, use the blue arrow. This allows creating quite flexible automations, turning on immediately when humidity reaches 75%, and turning off 30 seconds after it drops below 60%. In this example, the block, if any of the events occur, is used. Here, two or more triggers work. Pressing the switch button or double pressing a button toggles the chandelier state. This is the block execution of all conditions. The temperature value is selected below 18 degrees Celsius and the period from 9 p.m. to 8 a.m. If both conditions are met, green arrows, the state of the heater relay is checked. If the heater is off, it will turn on. A few more words about variables. These are predefined values and come in two types. In the main menu of the gateway, global variables are accessible to all automations. Let's create a global variable, name it CO2, data type, numeric, value, 1000. Save it. Here is our variable. Let's use it now. I create a new automation. As the trigger, I select the time period, every day, 24 hours a day. That is, it works constantly. Now select the block called device request. Here I mark the air quality monitor. Connect it to the trigger. Here, choose CO2 concentration. And now you need to specify the variable. In the global list, there is the CO2 variable we created. Now I choose the action that will occur if, during the day, the CO2 level exceeds 1000 units. For clarity, I'll use the familiar lamp. It will turn on, signaling an increased CO2 level. Within each automation block, you can also create your own internal variables. I name it temp, value, 20. Here it is available in the list of internal variables. But in other automations, it will not be visible, only within this block. The global one will be available everywhere. Of course, these are not all the capabilities provided by the gateway, but I think this is enough information to get acquainted with local automations. As you can see, their level is much higher than in the Mihome app, and they are stored not in the cloud but on your gateway, which, it seems, can become a sort of alternative to systems like Home Assistant, with known limitations, the main one being the ability to work only with devices from the Mihome ecosystem. That's all for now. I hope the video was useful and interesting for you. Share your ideas, examples, and real use cases for the gateway's capabilities in the comments. I'd appreciate your likes. They help promote the video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the description below the video, I'll leave links to stores where you can order this gadget, my Telegram channels, social networks, and groups for discussing smart home topics. Join in. It'll be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you soon. Peace to all.